guys, I understand that was quite hyperbolic, quite over the top. It was intentionally so. Because look, I don't know what's going to happen. A lot can change in a short amount of time. 2 years ago, we thought the idea of a Trump presidency was a fantasy. The idea of Brexit was a pipe dream. Both those things have happened. Guess who's back? The Nazis? Marching brazenly in the United States of America, like that country didn't fight a whole world war against them. Thing is, the Nazis, the original Nazis, the worst of the worst people that have ever lived. These dickheads now have the lesson of history and have still decided to be Nazis. That is fucking terrifying. But what I also know is that there are a lot more good people in the world than there are bad. Look at the amazing people that have come out for this show. And what I also know is that if shit were to ever go so south, we'd be there for each other. We would not allow that sort of oppression to ever take place again. Not just on religious grounds, for any reason. Which is why I propose a Punish a Nazi Day every day. Now, I don't want you to get the wrong end of the stick, Mark. I don't mean just going to McDonald's and look for a bald white guy and be like, hey, are you a Nazi or not? And then start punching him. And he's like, I'm not a skinhead. I just got alopecia. Leave me alone. There's no rewards or points that I'm giving out. All I'm saying, guys, the way to punish a Nazi is by doing things that they hate. So I want everyone in here to now testify. Put your hands in the air. Everyone, every single person, let's do it. Remember, we're on camera. Every single person, testify that I will punish a Nazi by not hating people who are different to me, by fighting justices, and mainly by using correct grammar. I've been Tez Ilyas. Good night. Allah bless. Thank you so much.